Today, VNR Vignan Jyoti Institute is conducting this convergence program. I think this is one of the very important program for engineering students, where they can showcase their technical capabilities. Because looking at what is happening in India today, in this highly competitive environment, technology is playing a large role in the growth of the Indian economy. And in this context, if you look at what is happening for the economic growth, that Indian government also is giving a lot of importance to the manufacturing sector. So in this competitive environment, the manufacturing sector has to grow. A lot of technology and innovation has to take place. I think the convergence and such kind of programs in engineering colleges play a long role in setting, putting the foundation for engineering students to become more technology and innovative driven. In this context, the other aspect we have to understand is looking at the Indian economy and its growth rates, we have a skew in the import and export basket, where the large section of imports consist of technology items like electronics, power plant equipment, telecom equipment. Everything is which is related to technology is imported into India. But at this growth rates, India has to succeed and create an inclusive growth. What is very important is innovative, low-cost technologies have to be developed in India. So for this to happen and the manufacturing sector to grow, a large section of this engineering colleges have to support the manufacturing drive in India. So such kind of programs will go in a long way to imbibe the students with creativity and innovation, which will help in the inclusive growth of India. Clearly, what I have discussed today in this presentation to the students is to tell them that as engineers, you have to develop your domain expertise. Whether you are an electronics engineer, instrumentation engineer, civil engineer, or a mechanical engineer, you specialize in your own areas rather than getting driven towards software. And because what is important is in the coming years, the domain expertise becomes very important for a student as a professional career or as an entrepreneur career. Unless you have a strong domain knowledge, you will not be able to sustain in the market as an entrepreneur or as a professional. In this context, this is what was explained to the student, because today's Indian environment is a highly competitive environment. And in this highly competitive environment, to grow professionally or entrepreneurially, a domain knowledge is very important. So for an engineering student, because somebody is paying high salaries, you get diverted to areas which is not part of your education, will not help you in a long run. Down around 15 to 20 years down the line, you will be left out. So as you increase your domain knowledge, as you age, you become stronger in the domain and you will have more value. This is what was presented by me in this meeting today. This what you look at is the IT field itself is maturing. So we are reaching a level of plateau where the Western world, where the IT industry was depend on the Western world, they are also cutting down on costs because their economies are not growing that high. So now there is a lot of pressure on the cost for the IT companies, and the IT companies have to become more innovative. So in this context, what happens is IT companies are also moving into higher end services, which lead to engineering services, product development, R&D, design services. So this require a lot of domain expertise. So the IT industry also is looking at students who have a strong domain knowledge. So in the coming years, what happens is the IT industry also will start looking at more and more expertise in the domain areas. So the students also, it's important that they have to develop this domain knowledge to survive in the professional market.